Chantal, and I am here this evening representing our Haiti committee. I was initially supposed to speak tonight for this weekend about Monsignor Goose's visit in August and also our Educated Child program. I had my little speech all prepared and Bill helped me put together a slide program. Well, unfortunately, as most of you know, earlier this week, Hurricane Matthew hit Haiti. The southwestern region of the country, where Chantal is located, was hit the hardest. The path of the hurricane went across the circle land and left immense destruction and death. Many of you might not know that this area of Haiti is the breadbasket of the country. It's the most fertile area, and this is where most of the country's food comes from. Chantal and the region around Chantal was hit the hardest. In fact, Chantal has the highest death toll in the country. Monsignor Goose was able to get a hold of Father Ed 2 days ago after walking 2 miles up the mountain to get a signal. He said that the parish hall is totally destroyed. The roof on St. John Church is damaged. 7 of the chapels are totally gone. The roof on Desjardins School is gone. And there's a picture of Desjardins School on the front of the bulletin. All the houses made of sheet metal are gone. The houses built of concrete remain, but 70% lost their roofs, and 20% have concrete damage. The Chantal School remains and is now the temporary shelter for the population of Chantal and Desjardins. Monsignor Goose has been in charge of feeding and clothing all the people. Monsignor Goose also lost all of his belongings and is down to having one shirt and a pair of shorts left and no bed. About 5 years ago, St. Cecilia's made a commitment, and I want to repeat that word, commitment, to twin with St. John Catholic Church in Chantal. St. Michael's in Whittemore has since joined in. That commitment or relationship is like a marriage commitment. For better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health. This tragedy is the worse, the poorer, the sickness that happens in relationships. In the past 5 years, we have nurtured and developed our relationship with the church in and around Chantal by our mission trips to Haiti and Monsignor Goose's trips here. And we have cemented that relationship. Many of the people of the parish churches Monsignor Goose serves are now hungry, homeless, and without any personal belongings. Throughout this tragedy, they have maintained their faith. My friend Josephine sent me a message 2 days ago. I hope you can do more for the people. Already, I thank you for all your help for the people of Chantal. I hope aid comes fast if God wants it to come. I believe our prayers will be granted because God is great and he will protect our community. Only God knows, my friend. God is great and he does all he can. All of us can make this one of our finest hours doing God's work by showing Monsignor Goose and the people of Chantal that we share the same faith that God is our protector and provider. Our committee has tried with no success to see if we can get supplies into Chantal. Unfortunately, the roads are impassable and it's too dangerous. We have contacted Catholic Relief Services, which has an operation in the nearest city of Lakai, and we have made them aware that Chantal is in urgent need of supplies. We are communicating with another mission group out of Iowa that is present in Lakai, and we are asking for their assistance and guidance. We plan on wiring Monsignor Goose money on Monday for his quarterly payment, and that should help with some supplies and food. Unfortunately, the bank is in Lakai, and he has not been able to get out of Chantal. Because there's no transportation, the river is too high, and the roads are impassable. Once he gets the money, also getting the supplies will be very difficult because of all the obstacles to overcome. Up until this week, our relationship with St. John de Chantal has been able to help them develop. Overnight, it's turned into helping them survive and eventually recover and rebuild. Monsignor Coos is a man of great faith, integrity, and commitment to his flock. We have witnessed his love and respect that the people of Chantal have for him. Through our personal relationships by traveling to Chantal and Monsignor Coos's trips here, we have seen how he has effectively and efficiently used our gifts to develop the schools and parishes. Now, we would like to replicate his love and charity and commitment by showing Monsignor Coos and the people of Chantal that they can trust us to help them in their time of worst, poor, and sickness. The Haiti community is reaching out to you today to continue praying for our brothers and sisters. We have placed envelopes in the pews. If you would like to make a donation for disaster relief to Chantal, please earmark it that it's relief for Chantal. Every penny that you give us goes directly to Chantal. If you need any more information, I'll be here after Mass. I'd love to share that with you, or you can contact the parish office. And I'd like to end with my favorite quote from an author unknown. To the world, you may be one person, but to one person, you may be the world. Let us be the one person to Chantal. God bless. See the face of Jesus in everyone you meet, and thank you.
We stand for our church.